Professor Font uses kitchen and day-to-day materials, toys, and other simple devices to communicate the wonder and joy of science to different age groups. The target participants of these workshops were school teachers. And this series of videos presented by Vigyan Prasad and Aisa Pune.
From the same price, you have a third experiment. That is to say, the flux of water out of the bottle, is perpendicular to the surface of the bottle. Here, at the beginning, it's horizontal, the trajectory. The salinity of water is higher than the salinity of escape from the earth. If it is a parabola, it is only a parabola because we are neglecting the variation of the gravitational field. But an arc of parabola or an arc of ellipse on 20 centimeter length, it is impossible to distinguish. But when we make the calculation to have a parabola, we negate that the value of the field, the gravitational field, is different from here to here. And of course, it is the same. It is the same. But if you imagine this experiment at very high, far from the Earth, you are still an ellipse. An ellipse has no point at an infinite position. So, in every book and every lecture on physics, and in every lecture I give about this curve, I say this parabola. But it is not a parabola. But of course, it's a parabola. Of course, because from here, from the soil to here, the gravitational field does not vary significantly. Okay? The shape of this curve, parabola or ellipse, depends on what? On the initial salinity here. When you study satellites, it is the same thing. You are the Earth as a material point, one way of the Earth, and something with an initial velocity, and to have a parabola, that is to say, to pass through the velocity of escape, you have to, for the Earth, to go over 111 kilometers by second. Speed of drop of water is about 1 meter by second. Every lecture in physics says that gravitational field does not vary from one point to another point. I think it's rather surprising.